there are several modifying factors that increase your risk for developing asthma or having asthma exacerbations and related air pollution. So one is socioeconomic status. If you live in a poor neighborhood, there are data to show that you have increased risk of asthma exacerbations. This might be multifactorial. You know, part of it may be poor access to healthcare, so you're not getting controller medications to keep your asthma under control. But it also may be that you have increased stress because people are shooting in your neighborhood and you're scared of that, or you're having a relatively poor diet because there are no supermarkets with good quality produce in your neighborhood and you're eating a lot of fast food. In any event, there are neighborhood factors and socioeconomic status factors that impact risk for asthma, increase the risk. And there are also racial ethnic differences. So some of this might be related to neighborhood and socioeconomic status factors, but there are actually genetic differences. It turns out that African American kids have a greater risk for showing up in emergency rooms with severe asthma than other racial ethnic groups. And Mexican-born Latino kids actually have a lower risk, for example, with Caucasians somewhere in between. And, you know, part of the problem with living in a poor neighborhood is that there's greater exposure to the pollutants. So not only are individuals perhaps more susceptible for the reasons we went through in the last slide, but they actually have greater exposure. And so there are three maps of Los Angeles on this slide. And the one on the upper left is showing the racial ethnic background. One on the far lower right is showing exposures. Exposures to diesel exhaust and to nitrogen dioxide, two traffic-related pollutants. And basically, you can see that these maps more or less overlie. The dark areas are where there's either greater minority residents, greater socioeconomic status disadvantage, poverty, and greater exposure. So this study from colleagues of mine at the School of Public Health at UC Berkeley pretty much shows that if you're a poor person of color in Los Angeles, you're liable to get more exposure to diesel exhaust and to nitrogen dioxide from traffic emissions.